warm welcome to everybody, and thank you for being part of the lecture of today, which is the second in the series of our character training program. Today is going to be unique because we're getting somebody who unarguably is the most experienced among all of us in the higher education firmament. And he will be sharing with us his thoughts on a very important subject of character building. The topic for today, as you can see, but let me just press on a little bit to remind you that the PhD holder, when you get your PhD and you get employed in a university, University of Burundi, a university in DRC, University of Ghana, or the University of Professional Studies in Ghana, University of Ibadan, anywhere, your letter of appointment will ask you to teach and will refer to research, and will ask you to render community service. So your appointment will be based on these three functions. Your promotion will also be based on three functions. And the society will recognize you by these three. But if you don't have character, all of these things will come to naught. So character is the backbone of all. So without character, you'll be useless to yourself and you'll be useless to society. That's why we have come up with this course, which is to help you build your character, build the backbone of character building. We are not deceiving ourselves that in 3 weeks, your character will change. But we are assured that with a little advice that you get from people who have been on this track before, that you will change your ways or strengthen good character that you have been developing. So let's welcome our facilitator for today, our lesson number two. He is no other than, well, just Nimi Briggs. That's how he refers to himself. He's a doctor of medicine of the University of Lagos. You know, in medicine, you have the MBBS or MBCHB, and that's, you say, doctor. But this one is PhD in medicine, doctor of medicine. So it's not a bachelor's, it's a doctor of medicine. He's a fellow of the Royal College of Obstetricians and Gynecologists, London. He's an emeritus professor of obstetrics and gynecology. All the women here are very happy, I'm sure, because you don't have somebody who takes care of you at birth, and pregnancy to birth and children. University of Port Harcourt. He's former vice chancellor of the University of the University, that's of Port Harcourt, and former chairman committee of vice chancellors of Nigerian universities. He's a distinguished fellow of the National Postgraduate Medical College of Nigeria. Professor Nimi Briggs is a distinguished alumnus of the University of Lagos. He's a member of the Court of Governors of the College of Medicine of that university. He's a member of STRATCOM, the National Universities Commission of Nigeria. He's an officer of the Order of the Niger, of the Federal Republic of Nigeria. He's the immediate past pro-chancellor and chairman of council of Federal University Local Jab, but is now the pioneer, that is the first pro-chancellor and chairman of council of Bayelsa Medical University, the recipient of the Hallmarks of Labor Foundation Award, very distinguished award, as a role model for outstanding contributions in the field of education. I'm so sorry, some people are coming here, I'm admitting them. He has served as a reviewer for several journals, including The Lancet. And you know Lancet is top of the range in medicine. He's widely traveled and widely published. Talking about being widely traveled, I recall my travel experience with Professor Nimi Briggs. We went to Al-Azhar University. Al-Azhar University is one of the oldest universities in the world. It was established 1,050 years ago. I don't know how old. I know University of Ibadan was established in 1948. University of Burundi, I think a little bit later. But this university was established 1,050 years ago. So we visited our university. And we also, Professor Briggs and I were also in Egypt. This is the Sphinx and this is the pyramid. So the man has traveled and the man has taken me along his travel journeys. So ladies and gentlemen, now time to hear the words of wisdom from Emeritus Professor Nimi Briggs, Pioneer Chairman of Council Bayelsa Medical University, on character and your responsibility in community service activities. Over to you, sir, Professor Nimi.
Thank you for that very extensive. Now, where am I? There we are. Let me start by thanking you for that very extensive introduction. No one does it better than you. You are the one who's carried me on all your travels. Let me put this slideshow. Is that slideshow now?
Yes.
Can you see the slides?
We can see the
slides. I'm trying to put it on slideshow. But are you seeing the slides?
Yes, sir. We can see the slide, but you can do slideshow from the beginning.
That's what I'm trying to do now. From the beginning. Okay, there we are. I think that's this one. There we are. Good. Right. I want to thank my chairman and the director for this wonderful program he's put up. And I welcome all my colleagues, my friends. The character building session is important because, as it was said, if you don't, the PhD you have will rather, instead of throwing you in the limelight, it will pull you down. So it's important that we do this. The session we have today reads Character and Responsibility of a PhD Holder in Community Service Activities. And the director has told us what community service really is. It is a very important aspect of your life when you come on to be a university teacher, or indeed wherever it is that you teach. I thought we should start with some definitions. First of all, we should look at what a PhD really is. And they tell us that the Doctor of Philosophy degree is the highest university degree that is conferred after a course of study. You have the bachelor's, you have the master's, and then you have the Doctor of Philosophy. Remember that the Doctor of Science degree is not offered after a course. That is offered depending on the amount of scholarship you have accumulated over the years, and you are recognized by a body of persons who feel that this amount of scholarship is sufficient to take you on to the higher level of doctorate. So the PhD you are acquiring now is the highest degree that a university offers after a course of study that you would have done. And we went on to define community. And if you look at it, it tells us that the community is a social group of any size whose members live in a specific locality, they share government, and often have a common cultural and historical heritage. They're also a group of people that care about each other and feel that they belong to one another. You can also define them just as a group of people. And if you look at this definition of community, it tells you that the community is very wide. So the area in which you as a university teacher would be expected to interact is very wide. But even before we go to those areas, whatever you do with yourself, the fact that you now have such a high degree, you've been educated to that level, demands of you some level of decorum. There are ways in which people would expect you, because you have a PhD, to behave in every community, in every society.
Correct.
Whatever it is that you do. And I've listed a few of them here. Of course, you should dress reasonably well. You should be simple, clean all the time. If you're a lady, you should not, with a PhD, go about flashing your breasts before men, wear dresses, pronounce your buttocks. If you're a man, you shouldn't go about attending classes in slippers, in jeans. You should be respectable. You should appear neat and simple. Alcohol, it used to be said that alcohol is good for the heart. The current medical evidence is that there is no information whatsoever to confirm the fact that alcohol is good for the heart. But a lot of people derive pleasure in taking alcohol. You can't take alcohol, but please, as a PhD holder, never be seen to be drunk. You shouldn't take it to the extent that you're on the road drunk, pushing up and down, Look at Dr. James, you know, he's drunk. That is unbecoming of a PhD holder. It will be stupid, I use the word stupid, and I use it advisedly for you as a PhD holder to be smoking. I say it's stupid because you should know by the level of your education that smoking is dangerous.
Yes.
And if it is dangerous, you should not do a thing like that. So if there are any of us here who are smoking, at the end of today's talk, you must take it that, I'm sorry, you are being stupid, and you should end that bad habit immediately. Your home should be respectable. You should not be seen fighting with your spouse. You should not be seen beating your children on the streets, pursuing them with a cane. Your human relationship should be attractive. It should be pleasant. You should be a pleasant human being. People should be able to vouch for your character. And at all times, you should be humble in everything you do. And talking about humility, there is no better example than our director. And our distinguished Professor Peter Okebukola will be humble to the child that is born today up to the man that is 150 years old. And that is a character in him, that is a trait in him I want you all to emulate before you finally receive that degree. You shouldn't go late to events. People look down on you when you advertise a time for X and you come for a time for Y. It does not matter. And more so when you are a PhD holder. Control yourself in everything you do. However pleasant what has happened is, however sad what has happened is, exercise control over yourself. Make considerations for others. Don't think that you're the only person on earth, you know. Remember that God created all of us equal. Consider others. Have personally those that are respectable. There should be limits to what you can do and what you must not do. You should be trustworthy at all times, and you should respect everyone you come across. Our director directed us that today at these lectures we should be as practical as possible rather than reeling out some theoretical and idealistic listing of character. So I would as much as possible obey those instructions. And for my community, because I've given such a wide definition of community, I will define my community as being, I listed about five here, so I'll very quickly talk to each of them. My university community, my hometown, my state, the country in which I am, and then, of course, global issues. How has my doctorate of medicine enabled me to interact appropriately in each of these areas I've described as community? First, let's take the university community. Our director did tell us that when the university employs you, they employ you to teach, to do research, and to offer community services. It's the issue of offering community services we're talking about. Now, community services even within the universities do exist. And these are the services you offer in order to ensure that the functions of the university will seem satisfactory. There are many, if you look at them, from chairmanship of various committees, head of department, provost or dean, vice chancellor, whatever. I want to say that by God's grace, I've been able to all these offices. And in fact, if you can look at the one of Vice Chancellor, I put a star there and I put three times. I have been appointed Vice Chancellor of the University of Port Harcourt on three different occasions. And I believe that that is because I have an integrity and I've maintained a good character. On these three occasions, twice as acting Vice Chancellor and then once as the substantive Vice Chancellor. If I had at the first time I was acting vice chancellor for 1.5 years, from 1995 to 1996, if I had spent all the university's money, if I had gone about dressing, going to work in slippers, if I had gone about sleeping with the girls, nobody would have appointed me an acting vice chancellor a second time. Nor would I even have been appointed vice chancellor. So I have written down here that you must, at every post in which you find yourself, you must be responsible. There's a sentence at the bottom there. If gold will rust, what will iron do? Let me explain how it came about. When I was provost of the College of Earth Sciences, we had the Senate meeting, and all the faculties were to make some submissions. It was only the College of Medicine that didn't. So the vice chancellor said, college, even you, what happened? So I said, what document are you talking about? It was then the registrar now made this statement. Sir, if gold will rust, what will iron do? But if you will do a thing like that, what will others do?
Yeah.
And then what transpired was when I went back and checked, we never received the document. So I came back to Senate the next Senate meeting and apologized, but then put the blame where squarely played. And rather, I now received the apology. And then they found that gold really does not rust. It's iron that rusts. So you must maintain a character and you must have integrity. With respect to my hometown, I'm from a town, we call it York City, called Abonima. Abonima is a city in the Akukujoro local government area. We speak a Calabari language. We are a people that are deep in traditional agriculture. We love education. Our religion is mainly Christianity. We have our own style of dressing, for men. Our girls, our females are very, very beautiful. This is a very beautiful girl. And if the first Nigerian ever to become a Miss World was from Abonima. Abanio Derego is an Abonima girl.
Wow.
And this is a girl ready for marriage. We are a riverine environment and our food is very, very rich. It's rich particularly in fish and crustaceans that are found in the sea. So when you are involved in your home society, in your home community, you should be involved in your home community in a positive manner. Respect is very important in your home environment. Respect your people as you see them. Speak your language. You speak your language when you're in your hometown. Don't come telling them that, you now speak only French, you now speak only English. Speak your language. Even if you're married at the church or whatever, find the way your people marry and try and associate with them. Try and get down your wife there and marry by your own native custom. Be generous to your people because most of the people there, you probably will be in a better position than them. If you can, look for a way of putting up a small bungalow in your hometown so that you can identify with your people. And as much as possible, when you're at home, wear the attires. Special occasions, special assignments will arise from your environment at home, and you must make sure that you're involved in them. There are a number in which I have been involved in my area. I've been involved in issues of conflict resolutions, church rallies to raise money, involved in identifying persons within the community that should receive scholarships. I've given many educational talks. This is one of them. And I've given special talks also. And then most recently, when the lockdown came into force as a result of COVID-19, our society, our community, our Mayanabo here, formed EMONI COVID-19 Relief Management and Administration Committee. I should say EMONI is the native word for Abonima and made me the chairman. And it mandated us that we should raise money on our own and try and feed persons in Abonima who are hungry. We did that. I believe that he chose on me to lead this team because he felt that I had integrity and I had character and that I was most unlikely to steal the money that would come to them. People must have that confidence in you because you're educated, because you had that level of education. And so far, we've raised about 13 million, and we have delivered a lot of food items, palliatives, and then people are very happy. We are proud to say that during the time of lockdown, that there was no thing that people were so hungry that they couldn't feed. At the level of my state, I have also exhibited a lot of integrity and character, and I've held several important positions in the state. Probably I just put down a few here. I just said I've served as the chairman of the State Economic Advisory Council, actually that was the council and committee. And then we advised the government for a period of 8 years on how their economy should go. And to be called upon as a doctor, a gynecologist, to look after such a body was no mean feat, and I feel quite proud about that. I was also the chairman of the State Electoral Commission, and that again is another very responsible position. And then when Port Harcourt was 100, a committee was formed to look into the activities of what should be done for Port Harcourt at 100. Whenever you are doing things that are important, please put them in writing.
Sure.
Make sure that documented. If you look at what we have here, this is our report on the electoral process this year, this year. And I dare say that up to the time we made these publications, there were no such publications from any state electoral body. This is the economic blueprint of the River State that we produce. This was the issue of what I was at the 100. All times, maintain their integrity, maintain their good character. Now, at the country level, again, I believe that because of my integrity, my character, hard work and trustworthiness, I've done quite a few things. I have been chairman of the Committee of Vice Chancellors, as our dear director has said. I've looked after the National Hospital. I've looked after the University of Benin City Hospital. I've looked after the Federal University of Lokoja as pro-chancellor, chairman of council. I've looked after the Bayelsa Medical University. I've given important keynote addresses. Just recently, the University of Ibadan Senate invited me to come and address them, which I did. Delivered the last but once Samuel Manual Lecture, which is a big, big lecture for the West African College of Surgeons. The 50th anniversary of the National Postgraduate Medical College, I delivered the keynote address and several other convocation addresses and all that. As Chairman told you, I'm a member of STRATCOM. These are some of the plaques and awards I have received. Please, at all times, let the fact that you are so well-educated make you humble, make you establish an integrity, make you establish a character, and make you work hard so that people get to trust you. That is the essence of higher education. It is not the other way around, in which you go about making everybody feel like a fool, that you are the only one who has won. It's not that way. At the global level, I was a member of the Commonwealth Universities Board. I do know that our dear Vice Chancellor of the University of Ibadan is now representing us on that board. I've had several activities at the Royal College of Obstetricians and Gynecologists in London. At the West African College of Surgeons, currently I hold a number of very important positions. Again, I keep harping on integrity, your character, your hard work, and people have to trust you. I can confidently say that all those who interact with me, trust me that if I say I will do something, I do it. Sure. If I say I will be in a particular place at a particular time, I will be there.
Yes.
If I promise, I will carry it out. Yeah, but right. God bless you all.
Wonderful.
I'm done, Chairman. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, sir. This is a very exciting, very moving. Very moving. I'm almost in tears. To thank God for you. You may stop sharing your screen, sir. To thank God for all that you are doing. To thank God for how God has imbued you with integrity, with character, that are now enabling you to do all that you have been doing. I want to now open the floor to our students who will asking our students, so I'm opening the floor for comments. I can see Dr. Bugoma Suwadu has raised her hand. So if you want to ask a question or there's an observation that you want to make, please raise your hand. Bugoma has her hand up. Yes, I've noted it. Who else? Just unmute yourself and talk.
Fetigu, sir.
Henry, sir.
Francis.
Okulabi.
Okay.
Fetigu, sir.
Yes, I got it. I got it.
Okulabi.
Yes, I got Professor Olabi, yes. Who else? All right. So we begin with Francis. And we go on to Professor Olabi. We go on to Fethigbo. And we anchor with Dr. So over to you, Francis.
Yeah, thank you, sir. Sir, observation shows that there are some people, even though they are well read, they are learned, they may even PhD holders, but they hardly go to their village because of fear that their people will harm them in one way or the other. They continue to stay where they are working for many years without going home. Sir, what advice will you give such a people with such a mentality, sir?
All right. Before I call on Professor Nimi Briggs, I want to ask you, Francis, where did you go home last? Or are you one of those that are afraid of going home?
Francis, make sense this lockdown period that has prevented me from going home. Every 3 months or even in 2 months time, 1 month, I used to go to my village, sir.
Okay, your village is very far. It means we are not giving you enough work in the university to be going home every week. All right, Professor Wolabi, you have the floor.
Thank you very much, sir. Let me first appreciate Professor Nimi Briggs, most especially for the support to our daddy and in particular to the center at large. My question is that in your days as Vice Chancellor, I want you to please share experience of a case of misbehavior among academics in your university and how you have been able to modify such, and also how you have been able to prevent a future occurrence of such. Thank you, sir.
All right, thank you very much. Right,
sir, thank you very much for the floor, sir. I sincerely want to say thank you to Grandpa Professor Nimi Briggs. I've actually been privileged to live amongst the Abunima people. I actually did my secondary school in River State, in Port Harcourt, precisely, in Abuloma, sir.
Abuloma.
So in Abuloma, sir, I have friends from that location, Abunime. They are a set of loving people, very wonderful. Actually, I had a classmate called Nimi Kukubo Briggs from your location. Mm-hmm. Now, thank you very much. They are a set of, they are really lovely people. Now, I want to add this, Dr. Francis have echoed my thoughts. As you gave the thoughts and the talk, sir, I actually got endeared because I wasn't groomed going on. I only went on once in a while, and it was in the latter years of my dad. He's late now that we started going on more often. But as Grandpa gave this talk, I was really endeared, and I began to think in my mind how I can manage to put this into my plan. I would really like to go home, know more about my people, because I'm really challenged. This is a man that is well learned.
I think we are losing her now. Okay. Now let's take on Dr. Bugoma Suwadu. Dr. Bugoma, you have the floor.
Okay, thank you. Thank you, sir, for the opportunity. I would like to thank you, Professor Nimi Briggs, for this great opportunity to remind us what we should be. So for me, it's not a question, it's a comment related to my experience. The problem for especially PhD holders in Africa is that most of us, we forget to do our old activities. It's like when you are getting your PhD, now you became another person, so you want to separate from your old activities, especially from your community. So for me, I think it's better, even if when we have our PhD, we do not have to forget our old activities. So this is the only way we can keep in touch, and we can change our community, especially their mentality. We have to be like them in the mind, even if we are PhD holder, but we have to be like, to understand that, like the same way we're dealing with them before our PhD degree.
Wonderful. That is a very good contribution, Dr. Bugoma Suwadu. So let me yield to Grandpa. You see, Fethibu, I can see your note. Look, Fethibu, if we refer to Professor Nimi Briggs as Grandpa, you can't call him Grandpa. It has to be great-great-grandpa for you. Fethibu, I hope you're hearing that. That's by way of a joke, by the way. So over to you, Professor Nimi Briggs.
Mr. Chairman, let me thank my colleagues and my good friends for the comments and the questions they've asked. I thank you for the fact that you enjoyed the lecture, and then we did say so. Four issues have been raised, and I'll go through them one by one. One is fear to go to the village because you are now an educated person.
No, sir. Not that they are an educated person. They are afraid, not educated. They are afraid that all the witches in the wizards in the village. You know, if this thing happens, we shouldn't push it aside, sir. There are some very bad people who are mysterious in their ways, and they can harm you. That's what they are saying. Not that they don't want to go.
I agree that there are some bad people like that. But I take myself as an example. I have not set out myself to harm any person. And then reciprocally, if any person sets himself or herself out to harm me,
correct,
I don't worry about it.
Absolutely.
I go about my business the way I need to get up. Prayerfully, I go about my business the way I wish to. But director, sir, there's also the other aspect where people feel that they are now so grown up academically that they don't want to associate with their people and they don't go home. That shouldn't be done. The fact that you've acquired such an education, as the director did tell us, the university has employed you not just to teach in the environment, but to make the world and the environment a better place through these activities, through such activities. And what one of the things you do is to go and associate with your people and enlighten them, bring them up to a higher level of interaction. So if people want to kill one, of course, nobody would say that if you see danger, you should walk into it with your eyes wide open. Yes. If somebody, you are aware that somebody wants to match at you with a knife, you run away. And that shouldn't be. Try and find ways of educating that person.
Sorry, Professor Briggs.
Yes.
What the person who asked the question fails to understand, I'm sure you understand, that's Francis, is that you need to go to the village to be harmed. They can, even if you are Francis, you don't need to go to the village to be harmed. You see, the technology that I'm in quotes now that these people have, they can reach you from anywhere. So I just thought I should mention that, sir. Yeah.
You did well, sir. The second question was, what did I do as Vice Chancellor about misbehavior of academics? You know, I whenever I'm in charge of a place, I try to get people to love me, to love the fact that I am the one there, rather than compelling them to obey me. I try to work in such a manner that they reach out to me as somebody whom they respect and like to be on that seat. Not because, they have no alternative. In other words, what I'm saying is that, yes, academics misbehaved when I was in charge, but some of the things I did was that I went to their homes. There was no home. I could say that, you know, quite categorically. There was no home when I was in charge that I couldn't go to at any time to sit down and discuss with the person that, look, this issue, how do you see it? How do you see it? So I had a very personal touch to the things I did. And I had I always have a very personal touch to my administrative ways of doing things. And that helped. Of course, at the end of the day, even with all that, you will have people who will still misbehave or what have you.
Oh, yes.
Of course, such persons, you brought the full weight of the law on them. Gotcha. And that I did, you know, on instances. But they were few and far between. By the way I described how I looked after the place, many people followed. They were just happy to come along with you to make sure that they join hands to improve the place. The other issue is Abulova and them going home. I thank the lady. I'm glad you were able to realize that Abuloma is different from Abonima. Abuloma is an Okrika town very close to Port Harcourt. Yeah. And Abonima, which I'm glad you've been to, is off. You have to travel from Port Harcourt for about 30 minutes. Our director knows he's been to Abonima.
Oh, yeah.
Abonima, I agree, which is a very lovely city. And it's a city that has embraced education right early, you know, because of their early contact with the Portuguese who came by sea. In fact, Dr. Napoleon Graham Douglas, who is reputed to be the first senior advocate of Nigeria, came from Abonima. So it's not only the Agbani Derivos who produce, we also produce the sands and the what have you. Abonima is a great big city, and I invite all of you when you are around Port Harcourt to visit Abonima. PhD makes you another person. They shouldn't. PhD should not make you another person. PhD should make you PhD should make you somebody that can rationalize, can now think through, can now see things the way the other person sees it and reason on it. And that's what that education should give to you. And I believe that if you set out yourself in that manner, provided your conscience tells you that you're doing the right thing, everybody will see that you're doing the right thing and they will associate with you. So those are the questions I was asked.
Oh, thank you so much, Grandpa. There are a few people who want to take the floor again. I can see that Mwambi. Mwambi, are you set to ask your question? Okay, is there another person? Oh, Professor, okay, yeah. Who else? I can take two more. If there is. Oh, VC, you are.
Yes,
okay. Yeah, one more. Going, gone. All right. So let's take our dear Vice Chancellor, University of Ibadan, Professor Abel Idowola Yinka. Take the floor, sir.
Thank you, sir, for the warm compliments, as usual. I think we once again thank Professor Nimi Briggs, and I think through the coordinator of the program, Professor Kebukola, I think it's really very exciting for us in the university system to think that there are people that we can always look up to. I mean, 2 days ago, when I learned that Baba Akinwunmi died, if I broke into tears.
Oh, yes.
Because it was always there for us.
Oh, yes.
In fact, we called them.
And
Professor Briggs is also entitled to that appellation.
Oh, yes.
That they are our living ancestors. They are living our living ancestors. Because they are icons. They have seen it all. And because there is nothing to reinvent. So we thank them so much. I mean, there is hardly anything that Professor Briggs has spoken about that you cannot relate to. So we just wish him many more years of useful service to the Nigerian university system and humanity in general. Yes. Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much, our Vice Chancellor, University of Ibadan. Professor Ochezewi, you have the floor, ma'am.
Thank you very much. I want to thank Grandpa for the beautiful things he had said. And I want to relate with that.
Yeah.
8 years ago, I was called upon by the women in my community to be their president. And everybody said, you can't do that. How can you come down to their level, A, B, C, D, E? And I said, okay, let me think about it. It now occurred to me that they are the ones that make the rules that guide us.
Oh, yes.
So we need to be there. So what I did was to accept that post, and then I drew other people, educated people. And we now started making laws. If you're very familiar with Igbo land and our burial rites, some of the harmful traditional practices they do to widows. Within the 6 years I was leading, I was able to cut all those off.
Wow.
Right now, let me just give the most common example. If any woman loses her husband now, and when I was trying that, it was a bit tricky, but the Anglican Church bought it. The Roman Catholics, it wasn't very easy for them. If a woman wants to barb her hair, it is optional. Nobody will sit you down and say, barb your hair. In fact, the Anglicans now took it to the other extreme that you will not do it. They will tell you it's not biblical and all those practices. They will sit the woman in one place and whatever. It was a lot of sacrifice because it meant my traveling from Nsukka to my village in Anambra State, OKTT, almost every weekend to support these women, because some of them believe that if they don't do some of those practices, they will die. But when I told them that they will not die, to the extent of going to sleep in some of their homes, you know. So when Grandpa Briggs was talking about relating with your community, right now I'm locked down in Nsukka, not in Anambra State, but they made me a member of the committee to share the palliatives.
Wow.
So I will be calling them on phone and telling them, go and give this person, go and give the other person. So it is all.
Wow. Oh, sorry, I'm losing you now. Okay.
Sorry. Thanks for recurring that. It is very, very important to relate with your people. Wow. Thank you very much.
So very much, my dear Professor Uchenna Nzewi. I think that will be it, because we have 1B, if you are still there, I want to ask a question, but apparently we cannot see that. So I'll have the pleasure of thanking Grandpa and to ask one of our students to make this presentation on our behalf. Let me see who I'm going to ask. Because Professor Nimi Briggs is an obstetrician and gynecologist, surely I'm going to ask one of the mothers in the house, you know, to make the presentation. Do we have Mercy Ibe? Are you active? Are you online now? I saw you in class.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, can you make this presentation? How many children have you got?
Five.
Pardon?
Five.
Ah, five. Five. So David has beaten you to it. David has six boys. David has six boys. David in DRC has six boys. David, just say that. You have six boys, and Madam Mesibi has five girls. Oh, five children.
Two girls and three boys, sir.
Wonderful. Congratulations. We thank God for that, for those blessings. So please appreciate Professor Briggs on our behalf by presenting this plan.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir, for the privilege.
Yeah, please go on.
Sir, please share the... I've not seen it.
Okay, if you can't see it, okay, let's get somebody else. Professor Oshina, can you please present this on our behalf?
Because that's a good one.
It's not on the screen, sir.
It's on the screen.
Lagos State. My screen has also jumped off.
Okay, let's just jump down. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, please go ahead.
Lagos Appreciation, Lagos State University, African Center of Excellence for Innovative and Transformative STEM Education, a World Bank project. This is to certify that Emeritus Professor Nimi Briggs facilitated the character training program for doctoral students in Africa, June to July 2020, signed by the distinguished Professor Peter Okebukola, OFR, the director. Thank you, sir.
Thank you also very much. Now we need to give a warm round of applause to our Professor Nimi Briggs, our grandpa, our everything. We wish him many more years of community service to all the communities, all the levels of communities that they are. Yes, sir, thank you so very much. So that brings us to the end of the second lecture. Tomorrow, the third bit, you know, I talked about teaching your role, your character as a teacher, which yesterday, the Vice Chancellor of the University of Lagos, you know, shared with us. Today is community service. Tomorrow is research. What character must you bring into doing research? And the person who is going to be facilitating it, sharing his ideas with us, is the Deputy Executive Secretary of the National Universities Commission. So until tomorrow, dear people, bye-bye.